This break.
Which break?
This break.
Here we have Master Ken McKenzie from McKenzie's Taekwondo in Voorhees, New Jersey. Master McKenzie is attempting to break his own world record of 28 cinder blocks with one blow. Nice axe kick right here, breaking the blocks.
Here it is.
Don't go surfing. There's exciting Masters demonstrations coming right up. We're looking at the beautiful art of Chen Tai Chi, performed by Master Ren Guangyi from Bronx, New York. All other styles of Tai Chi have developed from the style Chen.
Cynthia, Master Ren began his training as a young boy in Harbin, China, where his uncle introduced him to the 19th successor of the Chen style of Tai Chi Chuan, and that is Grandmaster Chen himself. He's performing an exercise where you can see him actually applying some of the technique with his student Darcy Johnson here. And this particular exercise is called pushing hands. And Tai Chi means literally translated grand ultimate fist.
It looks easy, but Tai Chi is very hard to perform. The complete body has to be relaxed and the breathing has to be timed with every movement. You know, Rick, I love watching this style, and the Chinese perform Tai Chi basically as a health exercise, not so much as self-defense, but to develop the internal system. Let's take a look at the award ceremony for the Japanese kata division. Kata is a Japanese term for forms. In fourth place is Osama Arkia from AGKAI.
Adam Older.
Third place winner, Adam Older from Bushi Karate.
In the second place winner is Cleveland Baxter, a shirin-ryu stylist and student of Toshiro Oshiro from Los Angeles, California. The kata that Mr. Baxter is performing is a ryu-ryu kata, Anan, which was developed by the coach of the Japanese national karate team, Master Sakimoto.
And let's give our judges and officials a hand as well as they hand out the award.
And Steve Robinson, the first place Japanese kata champion, arm raised by Cleveland Baxter there. What a show of sportsmanship there, Cynthia.
That's what martial arts is all about.
We have Master Manny Matthias preparing to demonstrate one of the power breaks made famous by World Oyama karate stylist. And you see it, he's kicking the baseball bat with the shin bone. This is a Louisville slugger baseball bat.
Now that's a core state slugger, much harder to break.
That's right, Cynthia.
I bet that hurt.
All right. And showing that determination pays off.
We're about to see a demonstration by Wushu stylist Pei Yun Li. Mr. Li will be performing the Chinese staff. The Chinese staff is quite unique from some of the staff forms that we see here in the States. The difference is the weapon is much longer, it's thinner, and it's very flexible. The reason for the flexibility, the judges will determine how much power and strength he has by how much bounce you'll see at the end of the stick. A little off balance there.
Now, Cynthia, if this were a competition rather than a demonstration, that little break in balance would detract from his score a little bit.
That could determine if he would win or not. But he recovered quite well, and he didn't let him phase him at all. Nice aerial technique. Very difficult to do with the staff in one hand.
It's interesting, you'll see he's using the entire mat almost like in a gymnastic floor routine.
It's the same thing, and if he steps out, that's points deducted if he was competing over in China. We have the winners from the Korean form competition in ring one.
In fourth place, we find James Buckley of the American Tongsido Academy from Pendel, Pennsylvania, performing Chinto, a student of Eric Stein. Third place, David Kremen of Amcor Karate in Aston, PA, and Timothy Clyde in second place, a student of Master William Ginyu.
And first place goes to Master John Godwin, who is the chief instructor of the Korean Martial Arts Institute in Delaware. As you can see, the Korean styles are noted for their high, beautiful kicking techniques. And a special thanks to the Philadelphia Kick cheerleaders and their coach Barbara Tiger for keeping score for us at the America Cup Karate Championship.
And the winners of the Korean Style Forms Division.
We're about to witness a spectacular demonstration of Korean kicking techniques as Master Brian Mattis exhibits his kicking skills.
The first technique we're going to see is a triple side kick. Notice he'll kick three times in the air without putting his foot down once. Looking at it again. Beautiful techniques.
Quite a demonstration of timing and skill.
Now he's going to perform a double jump front kick.
So this not only requires jumping skills, but the flexibility and the ability to kick in two directions at once.
And the power to break the boards at the same time. Finally, he's going to do the split kick, which your legs are literally spread out in a split position, kicking with both legs in different directions at the same time.
All right.
All three techniques, very, very difficult to perform with. World-class action continues when we return.